In South Carolina, there were 61 Little Leagues throughout that state. And in 1955, the 62nd League applied for a charter. This charter was for a league in Charleston, sponsored there by the Cannon Street YMCA.
Little League had no idea that they were an all-black league. Not that it would have made any difference. Little League here in the Williamsport area was integrated from the very start.
It seemed like the word went out across Charleston, all their neighborhood, that the YMCA is starting a Little League program. I'll never forget that day.
And suddenly Little League's Fort Sumter arrived with this Cannon League in South Carolina.
That started the war. But this time it's about baseball and it's about some black kids.
All 61 leagues were all white, and every team in every one of those leagues refused to play any team from the Cannon Street YMCA League.
They boycotted. They wouldn't play. We knew that.
And Little League wasn't going to hear of that. They said, no, you have to play them or you're going to forfeit.
Little League lost dozens and dozens of leagues in the South where racism was in vogue.
The all-white leagues forfeited their opportunity to compete for a chance to play in the Little League World Series in Williamsport. Instead, they arranged their own unaffiliated state tournament. And because the all-star team representing the Cannon Street YMCA did not, could not compete in a regional tournament, Little League tournament rules also considered those players and coaches ineligible to play in Williamsport.
The rule book, you know, said that you'd have to play your way to Williamsport. Well, nobody would play you. How can you play your way? That was our argument, but that's the rule.
The players couldn't compete, but they were allowed to warm up before the fans.
What made it even worse is when we saw that ball field. We had never seen anything so well kept. We played on crabgrass and rocks. And, you know, we were like, God, look at this. We took the field and we went through the routine, and then fans started chant. They started, let them play. Let them play. It was a protest. And so they knew that story. We went to our seats and we watched painfully.
They had to sit in the stands and watch the games, which had to be just very difficult to take for, you know, 11 and 12 year olds to understand why something as simple as baseball wasn't being afforded to them just because some adults in their own community didn't want whites and blacks mixing.
And isn't that a sad thing to not get that opportunity? My God, what would have happened to all of us? You just don't know. This all-black team win the World Series. You think about that even as now, like, what if, you know, what would have happened?
Little League, a history. For broadcast dates and times, check with your local public television station.